sick to figure out what to do. Some of our best teachers and the blessings in our lives are the diseases we get, are the pains we get, the suffering we get. You know, it's through our suffering that we wake up. Okay, so, and I want you to, if you have cancer, to realize this is not a death sentence. It's a wake-up call, that's all. It's just a wake-up call. And if you wake up and you do what is being asked of you, you're going to not only resolve the cancer, you're going to become an inspiration to everyone you love and all your friends. And they're going to say, wow, whatever he or she's doing, I want to do it. They look wonderful. Look at them. They've changed. Yeah, that's what happened. So it's a wake-up call. That's all it is. And if you understand that, then you rise to the occasion, then you're actually happy. And I've had so many people over the years tell me that the best thing that ever happened to them was their cancer. Okay, because the cancer woke them up from this crazy sleep that we have. We're in this hypnotic trance thinking that we can eat and smoke and drink. It's crazy. We don't do that to our cars. I mean, would you imagine buying a new nice car and not changing the oil about 3 to 4 times a year? Is your car going to run well? No. But you expect high performance of this without doing anything? Huh? I like to be straight and frank because your life depends on it. So if you want to hear nice words and you want to say, oh, that's okay, you can do this, then you can go somewhere else. But if you want to hear the truth because your life depends on it, that's what I'll do. I'll help you with that.